Hello, getting a high PageRank score for Google for PageSpeed is very critical for getting a good SEO rating for your website. I have optimized a client's website, arnoldussenassurantie.nl, and we've finally got a PageRank score of 100, both PageSpeed score, I should say, for desktop and for mobile, as you can see. I'd like to share a little bit how we did this. This is the website. It's not a complicated website. There's not a lot of special videos or other systems on it, but there are images, there's forms, there's animations, reasonably modern SaaS. So how do you get a nice optimized system? Well, first of all, the website is created in ModX CMS. ModX is the CMS of choice for me. It's flexible, it's powerful, you can build anything you need with it. It's PHP based. And the site is now hosted on ModX Cloud, which is the cloud-based service from ModX themselves. When you register there, you get a beautiful dashboard with where you can manage your ModX websites. You can copy any cloud instantly with a few clicks. There are daily automatic backups. Everything is optimized for speed. You can choose locations. Some websites for me are in America, others are in the Netherlands. So it's a really flexible and powerful way to manage your ModX websites. I highly recommend it. And it's very good for performance of your ModX website and as well as support, because the ModX team themselves are behind ModX Cloud, so they give you premium support for your ModX projects. If you go to GT Metrics for the website, we can see the almost 199% score. Why slow score is 90? Mostly because we don't use a CDN. I could add that if we need it, but for this client, that's a bit much. So that's not needed. As you can see, we have only 13 requests, which is really low. Page size is low, and the fully loaded time is 0.6 seconds, which is very fast and very good for Google ranking. All the other things, browser caching, well, you can't cache the Google Tag Manager, so this is not possible. These images can be 2 kilobytes smaller. Well, let's be fair, that's nothing. And the parsing of JavaScript, I'm already doing that. I'm splitting my JavaScript in two parts, the JavaScript that's needed for the header and the JavaScript that lead it later on the site. So I'll show you that. And for the rest, it's 100% scores. So I'm really happy with this. So the backend of the site, this is how ModX looks. I added Google Analytics inside the ModX system. As I told you, it's a pretty basic website, so there's nothing really special going on. Obviously, websites with a lot of video and a lot of huge images won't be able to get a 100% score, but the tips I'll share here are still needed for a good site performance. One of the main things you need to look for in ModX websites, if you want a good page ranking, is using the good extras, good plugins, to optimize performance. For this, I'm using a few things. Mostly Image Plus and PFump. These are plugins that can resize and optimize your images. SEO Pro and SEO Tab are useful for SEO. I also use PDO Tools, which is a very fast and efficient system to list menus basically or other items on your website. So let's look into the code a little bit. As you can see, this is the website. First of all, what I'm doing here is I'm loading two parts of JavaScript, one on the head, I call that main top. So this is the JavaScript that needs to be loaded first. The code that's in there, for instance, is modernizer and picture fill element for fallback for HTML responsive images in older browsers. So this is basically only the code that's needed to make the site work in very old browsers. So in Gulp, I use Gulp as a nice system to manage your scripts and your CSS. I grab these, I minify them, I put them in a folder, and there you get this file, main min and main top min. So all this JavaScript combined together, squished together, made as small as possible to make loading quick and efficient. The other JavaScript that's needed for the site, but that's not critical for loading, like jQuery, and it's based on Foundation, Parallax, Magnific Pop-Up I'm using. All these stuff can be loaded later in the footer. So these I load in the footer here, as you can see. And the Google Tag Manager I load in the footer, because that's not critical. So that way you get a nice way of loading the website. Another thing I use is, of course, minified CSS. So as you can see here, I have style.min.css. I use Sass, which is a nice way to manage your CSS. In Gulp, you can see here, I have a call here that basically grabs the file. It moves them and it creates a source map for the CSS. It minifies it, it combines it. Creates auto prefixer as well, and then it moves us to the folder production again. So here's the CSS file, the full one, and here's the minified one, which is just one line of code basically, which is of course fast and efficient. Well, this is the SAS code. As you can see, I load the CSS for Foundation, the icons, the Magnific pop-up, and I even load the Google font call. So yeah, that's basically the code for that. And of course I load that in the header here. Let's see where it is. Here, the CSS file, style.min.css. I load the minified version. What else is useful for ModX websites? As you can see here, the PDO menu. PDO tools is a very fast, efficient way to create menus in ModX, which is better than Wayfinder, for instance. So I highly recommend it. And I use responsive images. So if you could look at the homepage template, you can see I have a header here, a call. This is the chunk for the header, the HTML code for the header. I have a footer. This is the footer. And the homepage is just a little bit of content with an image background section, for instance. And what I do here is I have responsive images. So a picture element, HTML5. Picture element with responsive images, and for this I use Image Plus, which is a nice extra for ModX. And if you look at the options here, you can see that I resize the images to the exact width needed. So for screens that are maximum 480 pixels, I don't need a picture that's bigger than 480. So I resize the image to 480, I give it a height to create the aspect ratio, and I give it a quality. So the images are also optimized to make them smaller. And then I add a retina image, so if there's a retina phone on this screen size, it will create an image twice the size of it. And I do this for a lot of screen sizes, as you can see, which allows for a lot of art direction, which is nice, but mostly it improves performance because it will never load an image that is larger than needed. If the screen is also only 1280 pixels wide, you don't need an image that's 3000 pixels wide. So that's why it's efficient and fast. So as you can see, the site is just extremely quickly to load, under a second, which is perfect for SEO, and just a very nice way. So in short, I use ModX for the website, ModX Cloud for hosting, powerful, efficient, easy to use, Sass and Gulp to minify my JavaScript and CSS, and I use responsive images to optimize my image sizes. Once you have these, you can visit, of course, PageSpeed Insights. Have it go through there. If you see any errors, you can always check if you can fix them. As well as, I like this one, GT Metrics. Here you can check out the waterfall. So how long does everything take to load? Here we can see that the initial load to connect to the server, basically, and it takes the most of the time. This is unavoidable. This is already very fast and low. But this is, your server will have a certain time it needs. If this is too high for your website, you could consider optimizing your hosting to a faster system or a better location. But this is not usually not something you can change a lot about. But for the rest, it's critical. My CSS is very small, only 22 kilobytes. My JavaScript is very small, the top one is only 7 kilobytes, so that loads very quickly, as you can see, at the same time. As you can see, just an image like a logo, that takes a little bit of time, obviously. This is the one image for the site, a larger image, so that you can see that those take take time. And then you can see once that's loaded, it will load the main JavaScript that's in the footer. So this way, it will already render the page a little before the JavaScript is loaded. Google Analytics will take some time, of course, and these are some other images. The Google Fonts is also one thing. If I wanted the site to be even faster, I could use default fonts. But of course, you do want the site to look nice, so there's not a big issue here, I think. So this is very fast. I'm really happy with this, and thank you for watching.